From Armen Akhnoudzhanyan. From me, Armen Akhnoudzhanyan, a progressive politologist. Actually, I agree my views with a liberal message, and I, as a political commentator, liberal political commentator, I'll try to be very progressive in terms of covering recent Washington events. I believe MSNBC was trying to intimidate, you know, views with a threat of a possible shutdown of a federal government, and, which actually unlikely to happen because Republican House of Representatives Speaker Boehner, but he doesn't want shutting down the government. And actually, if Republicans threaten to shut down federal government, they actually will be the one to blame for shutting down the federal government. Because there are right-wing extremists, neo-fascists, who wants to only to be elected of a rich and wealthy imperialist who pay them illegal finance donation, illegal campaign donations. You know, we actually lucky of those right-wing extremist groups who finance them and, you know, who give them moral support. Actually, I believe that Democratic President Obama should actually avoid shutting down the government and should immediately ask the Senate leaders, you know, to pass the budget, the Democratic budget, presidential budget, which includes $1.3 trillion increasing taxes. So that would be able to increase taxes against wealthy individuals and rich corporations in order to pay more for increased spending for healthcare and social programs and education and transportation and homeland security operations and law enforcement operations as well. And I believe that spending for social needs and education should increase. And healthcare, spending for healthcare should increase as well. And when we take those money, we'll raise taxes with $1.3 trillion, so it's including presidential budget, against those wealthy individuals and rich corporations, very poor American public, every day. And it's outrageous. They're ripping me off, stealing my $10,000 of savings by closing down corporation MPC, you know, and I couldn't find a lawyer to sue them because those lawyers was neo-fascist, and they were, you know, hated immigrants, you know, in Los Angeles area. And I believe that some of those lawyers even charged me, about $3,000, $2,000, so I upfront, so we make sure that I will be able to hire them, so to follow the negotiations, you know. Actually, I believe that there is a progressive solutions to the problem of budget deficit. Raising taxes against wealthy corporations and rich individuals is a progressive solution to a problem of budget deficit. And I believe President Obama should brace himself for better progressive solutions. And he also should, I believe that his condition, his mental state, started to deteriorate recently because he actually mentioned that he will what kind of questions would it be if we ask him how many times he has one had his one wife, you know, and he was a little bit asking a psychopathic question, and I believe he should seek psychotherapist help, you know, call psychotherapist or call me, my cell number 323-445-1600, if you want to consult me, because I'm a strong supporter of Democrats. I'm a member of Democratic electoral campaign committee, you know, and actually I'm liberal candidate for District 8, you know, city of Los Angeles, and actually I will help him as a Bachelor of Psychology, actually, with 3.5 GPA average. I will be able to, you know, provide some serious psychoanalysis and brainwashing for President Obama and help him to get rid of his psychopathic, you know, tendencies. because it's a lot of suffering. I believe it's homeopathy. It was disease of one's symptoms I observed in President Obama. But he is mean-spirited and deleterious remarks sometimes make it. So that come to terms of city of Los Angeles, I believe that Mayor Antonio Villaraigosa is a Democrat. He's engaged in a scam, running a scam, because he tells the public that Los Angeles doesn't have school, high school students. They don't have a football stadium. And that's why he wanted to give away millions of dollars, you know, of illegal giveaway to corporation Anschutz Entertainment Group. Which is a ripoff in terms of SK probably hopes to get receive kickbacks from the Anschutz Entertainment Group, like in illegal campaign donations and bribes. And I believe that high school on Sunset and One Night Boulevard, we have a football stadium. Football, America football stadium, which is American football stadium. We was Honey Gates, you know, sending out and and Los Angeles doesn't have any money to build any stadium, and don't have any free space to build any stadium. Place doesn't have Los Angeles City doesn't have any large spot, you know, to build any stadium on. And the prices for the state are increased by those narco-mobsters, you know, who actually charge mad kind of money for the land, you know, near Los Angeles downtown. And I believe that President Antonio should actually investigate that Anschutz Entertainment Group as a racketeering group that engages in probably corruption, corrupting or giving bribes and illegal donations to Mayor Los Angeles Mayor Antonio Villaraigosa in order to avoid to fight the public corruption. Well, actually, I believe that the Democrats will find solution of a problem, progressive solution like establishing living minimum wage of $10 an hour, of granting amnesty to non-criminal illegal aliens, which I'm committed very much to granting asylum and amnesty to illegal non-criminal illegal alien workers, also granting amnesty to ex-felons who earned led a law-abiding life for the last 5 years. Also, I'm committed to providing issuing marriage certificates to same-sex couples, to homosexual lesbians. I will provide them marriage licenses, 1, 3, 5, and 10 years marriage licenses. Well, actually, and also I'm more committed to cutting taxes for middle class and poor homeowners, so we could fix their failing health problems and fix their property as well, and raise taxes against wealthy people who make more than $60,000 on an individual basis. Because with my criteria of being wealthy, as I haven't seen any my friends would make more $60,000 individually for home or life. It's practically impossible to find those, except that in an elite. And I believe President Obama gave, unfortunately, he made a big mistake by giving loopholes to wealthy, because he told that he wanted to raise taxes on people who make more than, less than $250,000 individually. But this is outrageous. People who make from $100,000 to $250,000 are wealthy people, and the tax again should be raised because they rip off their brokers, they rip off their investors. Like I got ripped off and my life investment was stolen by MPC Corporation, which I'm going to sue, and I'm going to sue and recover damages, you know, and because they ripped me off and stole all my life savings. And now I cannot pay even tuition for college, you know, because I've been ripped off and robbed, you know, by those, cheating crooks, you know, from those MPC Corporation. And I demand some social justice. And I demand more housing vouchers. Yeah, as a liberal Democrat, I have a solution for problem of housing, which was a reactionary Democrat that Antonio Villaraigosa just only posed questions. Issue, I want the city government to issue housing vouchers to poor destitute Angolan workers like me who stand in line, you know, signed up land waiting for Section 8. Issue of housing vouchers and give them away and expedite issuance of those vouchers in order to avoid more riots, more strikes, more assassinations, and more federal indictments against those corrupt politicians.